Hello and welcome to My Secret Math Tutor. For this video, I had a special request to see how the quadratic formula was built using the method of completing the square. Now, of course, if you're not familiar with completing the square, go ahead and check out my video on how that works. It's a really great way for solving some quadratic equations. And of course, it's how the quadratic formula gets built. All right, so let's go ahead and jump right in it. The idea is that we're trying to solve a quadratic equation. We're going to do this in the most general way possible, so I'm just leaving a, b, and c as my generic coefficients in here. And of course, those could be any number. Our goal is to really try and isolate x on one side through that method of completing the square. And of course, by the time we're done, we will have that quadratic formula. All right, so where do we start this process? Well, if you're going to complete the square, the first thing you want to do is kind of want to isolate your variables here. So I have this c, you know, I really want it on the other side, so I'm going to subtract c from both sides. So that'll give me ax squared plus bx equals minus c. Okay, good place to start. Now, I also like to isolate the x squared term, make sure that it doesn't have any coefficients out front. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to factor it out, and I'm going to factor it from both of these terms. So I'll have a multiplied by the quantity x squared plus b over a x, and that's all still equal to negative c. Now, when you see a step like that, you know, it's kind of intuitive, like, yeah, the a is going to come out. I can see where that came from. But why all of a sudden does an a show up over here? It really should end up as a fraction. And one good way to double check that this is the proper way to factor it out is imagine taking this a and actually putting it back in. So a times x squared, there's my ax squared. If the a multiplies over here, it would actually cancel with that a in the bottom, and sure enough, we'd be just left with a b. So that is the correct way to factor out that part. All right, things are looking pretty good. I want to move that a to the other side, so let's go ahead and just divide both sides by a. See where that takes us. All right, so I have x squared plus b over a multiplied by x equals negative c divided by a. And I'm really setting this thing up so I can complete the square. I've made sure that my variables are on one side. There's no coefficients in front of that x squared. In fact, I'm in really good shape that I can actually move forward and say, all right, let's go ahead and complete that square. Now, again, this is a really good time if you haven't seen this method to go back and check out my other video. Otherwise, let's go ahead and move forward with this guy. When it comes to completing the square, we're going to look at this term next to x, in this case the b over a, and we're going to do something very special to it. We want to divide this by 2, so let's go ahead and put the little 2 in the basement, divide by 2, and we're going to square it. This will, of course, give us a brand new number. This will give us b squared all over, let's see, square of the top and bottom, 4a squared. And this new number right here is what we can use to go ahead and complete the square. We're going to add this on both sides of our equation. It looks a little complicated, looks a little ugly, but it is exactly what we need to make this thing work out. Okay, so there's the left side of my equation. Let's go ahead and throw that in there. Plus b squared all over 4a squared. And here's the other side of our equation. Of course, we have to balance this equation out. So let's go ahead and add b squared all over 4a squared to the other side. All right, so we've put this on both sides. How does this really help us? Well, this is going to make the left side factor nicely. And it does get a little bit tricky when you get some weird terms in there, like b squared all over 4a squared. But, you know, let's just go ahead and focus on that left side, see what happens, make sure that it really does factor like it should. So I'm just going to copy down the right side. We won't touch that for a bit. And the way I like to do this is let's just look at the first terms. What two things would multiply and give us an x squared? Well, those would both have to be an x. What two things would have to multiply and give us a b squared? Well, that would have to be a b. So let's put that in the top of a little fraction up there, b. And what would have to multiply in order to get a 4a squared? Well, a 2a multiplied by a 2a, that would do it. So sure enough, I'm setting this up pretty good, and we have it factored. Now, we have these fractions here. Again, it looks a little weird. How would my outside and inside terms really multiply to give me a b over a? It really does. In fact, if we want to just check it, the outside terms would be x over b over 2a plus plus xb over 2a. They have a common denominator, so you'd end up with 2x over, or 2xb all over 2a. The 2's cancel. And those are xb over a. That really is how this thing does factor. All right, so what does this give us? It says that we have two factors, x plus b over 2a. And since we have two, they're being multiplied, I'll say they're squared. And that's all equal to the right side. So we've completed the square, and the really neat part about doing that is we started with an x squared and an x, and now we just have a single x here on the left side. So now, as soon as we do some combining, we get that x all by itself, sure enough, we will get this quadratic formula. Let's go ahead and move forward. So the next step in this is to really try and combine as much stuff as possible here on the right, and then we'll go ahead and take the square root to move that 2 out of the way. And if we're going to combine things over here on the right side, we need a common denominator. You know, this has a 4a squared, that just has a single a. So what I can do to this guy right here is I can multiply the top and bottom of that one by 4 times a. So maybe we'll just make a little note. This will be 4 times a. Top will also be 4 times a. All right, now I'm going to write this just to make sure everything is ordered nicely as negative 4 AC. In the bottom, I'll have 4a squared, so that looks pretty good. And here's b squared all over 4a squared. Okay, so that's all looking good. In fact, we're already starting to see pieces of the quadratic formula show up. There's b squared, there's minus 4ac. It's all looking great. But anyway, the important part is that we have that common denominator, so we'll go ahead and combine these into a single fraction. All over 4a squared. I like it. And as long as we do have these into a single fraction, you know, the order of addition doesn't really matter. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to just flip-flop these around. I want to put my b squared over here. I'm going to put the 4a over there. So we'll say this is b squared minus 4ac all over 4a squared. Now, I haven't touched the left side. Of course, we're just holding on to that. We'll get to it in the next step, but it's really still there. We'll get to it. But you can see, yeah, there's that quadratic formula. We're starting to build it. Now let's go ahead and work with the left side, get rid of that square, and get this just a little bit closer. All right, so the next step, what shall we do now? Well, we're going to take the square root of both sides. Now, when you take the square root of a variable that's already squared in here, not only will it get rid of that square, so we'll end up with just x plus b over 2a, but we actually end up with a plus or minus possibility. You know, it could have been a positive variable, could have been a negative variable, we don't know. So we have both those that we have to take into account. All right, looking better and better. Now we have our square root in there. And on this side where we have the square root, we can go ahead and take the square root of the top and the square root of the bottom just to make it a little bit nicer. Now the top is a fairly ugly, complicated looking thing. So I'm just gonna leave it as the square root of b squared minus 4ac. That looks familiar. The bottom, however, those are fairly nice numbers. We can go ahead and take the square root of that. Square root of 4 is just a 2. Square root of a squared is a. So that's not a problem. All right, and now we are almost there. So in the next step, let's go ahead and work on getting this x all by itself. Let's move that b over 2a to the other side. Since it's added on the left, we will subtract it to get it to the other side. All right, now we're almost home free. We've isolated our x, so that's pretty good. These are essentially two fractions, and they already have the same denominator. That's great. That means we can actually take these two fractions and put them together so that they're all just one single fraction. In fact, what fraction does that make? Let's find out. Negative b plus or minus the square root of b squared minus 4ac all over that common denominator of 2a. And sure enough, there's our quadratic formula. And you can see it really is just a process of running through completing the square, but doing it very carefully at every single step, making sure you simplify, making sure that you get that common denominator, and there you go. You have the quadratic formula. All right. Hopefully you enjoyed this video. If it helped you out, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to my channel. If you'd like to see some more videos, please visit MySecretMathTutor.com.